stormy seas and lost souls.
She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye.
But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us?
Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares? Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes.
Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You fail the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be? Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
Split personality on top of everything else, huh? That's rough.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you.
Oh, take it easy.
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just do like it. Your sword. Come on.
We'll get through this, Senua.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling, a song.
Sometimes all we have is curiosity to see what will come. Truth?
It's a trick, don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in yourself?
Wait?
No. It's a trick.
Dillian? Whichever it is, I don't know if it's a good idea to follow our dead lover's voice. Oh well. I guess, I don't have that much of a choice. It's pretty much just a straight route. Wait, can I go this way? Can I find anything here? Explore the beach, take a swim? Wash up, maybe? It's very pretty. That's for sure. Oh, invisible wall. Oh, I guess this is as far as we can go this way. But at least we, had a little bit of a walk in the water. Alright, so step by step.
There it is. You're imagining things. It's Dylan. He's gotten you
If we ignore the pain, we might hurt ourselves even more. But I guess the game is not gonna give us much of a choice, is it? And across we go. Careful. Careful. The ships are very, very nice. I hope we don't have a broken rib or something. It might result in something worse than just pain.
Before she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zimbal, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
Well, you have me here so you don't have to be lonely. We're running easier.
There he was. Where is he? The lone figure of a boy.
He's there. Under the tree.
Swordplay under the shade of a tree.
That's far.
She remembers the first time she saw him.
Under the tree.
To her young eyes, he moved as if dancing. And the world danced with him. The gloom. First time in years, she felt a ray of hope.
Hello there, Symbol.
The Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigmund. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him. So King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
Nice guy. All right, Senua. Remember to breathe. So many ships wrecked over here. So many. What's this? Seaweed? Seems that.
Day after
I guess
day,
it's low tide.
Watching from afar, she mimicked him, perfecting her own secret dance. Wishing those fleeting moments of light would stretch out to last forever.
Oh, more to see. What are you?
Death for Sigmund and his brother seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for Sigmund, because he plans an even more cruel adventure. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end?
Indeed, to what end?
Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
She licks his face and becomes good friends with her? don't know. I don't know a connection between wolves and honey. That's bright. Huh? Where are we? We look different again.
How does he so effortlessly court the world and bliss?
If only she could do the same. See the world through eyes anew. And dance with it. Just like he does.
I guess this is a memory of sorts. Probably of home. Let's take a few more running steps. Good to see you smile.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you. And
you learnt all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dilly. I'm here for the warrior trials. Would you come and watch? And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment. When you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northmen took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things work. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No!
And all your suffering will have been for nothing!
Shut up!
We'll make sure that that's not going to happen. We'll get to him. We will.
That tree. Can you see him? You want to believe it. Is he not real? Is he there? You're alone in these mountains. Is that Dillian? Nothing lives here.
This is hardly a mountain.
You met him by the tree. She met him by the tree. Maybe it's a sign, the tree. What's he trying to tell you? He's waiting for you by the tree.
Need to find a way to the tree first. Maybe I took a misroute. I thought that I couldn't get across the rocks, but perhaps I was wrong. So many skulls here, huh? What's this? A sword? Is it his?
Take it. Sword. A sword. Take it. Dillian left it for you. Take it. Take it. Take it.
Wait, this is like...
happening?
Cinema, imagine a sword that can slay gods.
Oh, so it is the sword.
Is Gram.
Of Odin.
It was forged by the god of all Northmen, Odin, and gifted to Sigmund, a great warrior.
I need this sword. It's important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gram by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards. Go to the shard.
Go to the shards.
I see.
Shard. Find it.
So now it's instead of two trials that we faced before, we're facing three.
Find it. The metal.
Very well.
The runes. You need that sword.
So
go
be
to
it.
The shard. Find the shards.
We will continue with these trials next time. Thank you for watching. See you soon.